Walker and Mason's history lesson. The issue that the Virginia and New Jersey plans were attempting to resolve was the issue of representation in Congress. With the more populous states wanting representation to be proportional population and the smaller states wanting to be set at a specific number per state. Virginia plan proposed a strong executive, a national judiciary, and a strong two-house legislature. The lower house was chosen by the people, and the upper house was chosen by the lower house. The Virginia plan favored more populous states, bigger states. On the other hand, New Jersey proposed a weak executive with a national judiciary with limited powers. The New Jersey plan had a one-house legislature, with one vote each for a state. This plan favored the small states. The Virginia plan and the Jersey plan both planned to make changes to the Articles of Confederation in different ways. The Virginia plan created a stronger national government.
The Virginia state plan were represented by populations instead of each state equal at the New Jersey plan.
The Great Compromise proposed a legislative branch with two parts. Representation based on population, and Senate with two members for each state.
Okay, this gave the larger states an advantage in House and the smaller states an advantage in Senate.
Thanks for watching. This is Walker and Mason's history lesson.
The Virginia plan proposed a strong executive, a national judiciary, and a strong two-house government.
I feel like a Gucci ad-lib.
I'm a do